concepts and understand them better, we have with us Amit Shah, Technical and Derivatives Analyst at BlockMs. And here, Amit and I are talking about futures premium and discount, or in one word, basis. Now, the price of a futures contract is usually higher or lower than the spot or the underlying price by a few points. And this difference between the futures and the spot is known as basis. So, Amit, you know, before we start get through the concept, why don't you tell us with a real-world example about how this concept of basis works?
Right. So, as you rightly said, that the future price is always different from the spot price. So, let's understand this example with the example of milk.
Right.
Say, for example, the price of a milk is 50 rupees a litre.
Right.
Now, we know that the curd is derived from milk.
Right.
So, definitely, if I want to, from that 1 liter of milk, I want to prepare curd. So, definitely, there is some processing charge. You will, once the curd is formed, you will store that curd into a refrigerator or something for the curd to form. So, can I say that the processing charge, etc., will be slightly higher and compared to the cost of milk? So, if my, so just assume that the cost to prepare a curd is, say, 2 rupees. So, my milk for 1 liter of milk is 50 rupees. So, the curd price will be somewhere higher than the price of the milk. And if the price of milk is increasing or decreasing, simultaneously the curd price also gets impacted because the underlying product is milk from where it is derived. So, the spot or the underlying price becomes a milk in this example, and any derivative contract, futures, or it is nothing but the curd. So, as and when the price of milk will increase or decrease, simultaneously the price of curd will get proportionately impacted.
Okay. Right. So, Amit, then let's talk about this and apply this in the practical world of the futures space. You have a futures price of, say, for example, the Nifty.
Right.
It would be around, somewhere around 11,550.
Right.
And your spot is somewhere around 11,500, you can say that.
Right.
How would you determine and work around these levels?
Right. So, just relating the curd and the milk example, as we have the processing charge, storage cost, in equity derivative market, we have the cost of tenure, which is nothing but the interest cost.
Right.
So, if my contract is trading at a premium, so this means, for example, what you are suggesting, a future trading at 11,550 and spot trading at 11,500.
Right.
This means that my future is trading at a premium, which is an ideal case scenario. Most of the time, you will always see the price of the curd is always higher than the price of the milk, right? So, this is an ideal case scenario where the future is trading at a premium compared to the spot price.
Right.
And this is, and theoretically, this is called the case of contango, or the premium where the future is trading at a premium. There are cases when the future price does come into a discount.
Right.
Now, there are two broader possibilities. One, if a company is declaring a dividend, at that point of time, definitely the dividend benefit is given to the underlying stock, not to a derivative holder. So definitely the spot price is trading at a level, same level, but the future price automatically gets eroded by that dividend amount.
Okay.
So this is a case where the future price will be trading at a discount compared to the spot price.
Okay.
The other thing is, when there is too much of supply, or there is a short position getting added into the future contract, that's when the spot or the future price, because of the intense supply and the underlying stock is not getting impacted because speculators or traders are entering a short trade into particular stock or index, which is pushing the price lower. So this is the second scenario where there is a possibility where this future price will trade into a discount compared to the spot price. Theoretically, this is a case of backwardation or the future trading at a discount.
Okay. Amit, so let's put this in numbers. Let's say, for example, have the underlying at around 150 for that particular security, and its futures is trading at 153.
Right.
I'll talk about the discount a little bit later on, but how would you interpret this situation at this point?
Yeah, so this is definitely a case of a contango, which is a normal case scenario, where the cost of carry is 3 rupees, which is the interest cost for that particular expiry, which is demanding a 3 rupee premium. So this is a pure case where a future is trading at a premium of to the spot, and the premium is 3 rupees to the spot price.
Okay, and let's talk about the discount. Assuming that the spot price is at 150, but the futures is trading at, say, something like 147.
Right. So this can be the case in case if a company has declared a dividend,
right,
which would be equivalent to 3 rupees on, because the future is discounted by 3 rupees. This is the pure case where a company can declare a dividend with the same amount, or in case if there is an intense supply, which is there in the future segment, assuming that there are traders, speculators who have a negative view on that particular stock for that particular expiry. So what happens is the underlying stays muted, there is not much of a demand or supply price fluctuation which is causing the price impact. But because there's few speculators who are having a negative view on this particular counter, they are creating some short positions on account of which the future price is getting more supply and pushing the price lower to the spot price. So these are the two ideal case scenarios where a future can create a discount. Okay, so that's simple enough. Pavel, thank you for taking us through this concept of premium and discount. Of course, we did